Welcome back to Energy and Cleaning. Today I'm going to show you the easiest trick to help you refresh pillows, throw pillows such as this, throw blankets such as this, towels, linens, curtains, anything that you have that you want to make smell better and fresher. So easy. And it's not vinegar or laundry stripping. If you're curious about my opinions about laundry stripping, I will link that in the description box below. Let me know if you've run into this before. You have company coming over and you wanna put new bedding down, but it kinda smells like your closet and you just wanna freshen it up. It's clean, but you wanna make it smell nice, yes. Or you have children, I have four of them, and when you put them to bed, you can tell they've been drooling on their pillows and it's stinky and it's not quite ready for laundry day. By the way, if you wanna know my favorite trick to make it so you never ever have to fold a fitted sheet again, it has to with this right here. I will link that video in the description box below. Clever refresh. Grab yourself some witch hazel, or you can use rubbing alcohol if you have it on hand. I have a whole video about this right here. Get yourself some distilled water. I just use what was in my refrigerator, you know, and you push a little button. I have an amber bottle right here. This helps the longevity of your essential oils right here. Now, if you don't have these amber bottles, that's just fine, but I got a 6-pack of them. They were relatively inexpensive. I can link that all below as well. And then your favorite essential oil. We're gonna use a lavender here because it's not too overpowering, and if you want to do a little refresh before you go to sleep at night, it does have relaxing qualities. Right here, I just have the 1 cup of water, and I'm going to add anywhere between 1/4 cup and 1/2 cup of this witch hazel right here. Now, you want to use witch hazel or rubbing alcohol so that it can help kill the odor-causing bacteria. Yes, that is the key right here. Something like a room spray that doesn't contain an alcohol component is only going to cover up the smell. So you want to make sure that you're using something in your room spray combination that's going to kill that bacteria. So I did about 1/4 cup right there, and now I'm gonna do about 20 drops, 15 to 20 drops of this essential oil. It's totally contingent upon how pungent you want your room spray to be. Couple things I wanna point out here. I do love Febreze or some Mrs. Meyers spray, but sometimes it's a little too potent, especially if you're using this for guests or you have company coming over. So I just like to use something a little less pungent. Now, every time you use this, you wanna make sure that you give it a good shake before you spray in your designated area. I have 6 different places that I like to use this throughout my cleaning routine. In fact, every morning I engage in this routine right here when I'm putting a load of laundry, and I like to refresh pillows and sheets so it's all nice right before I go to bed. Sometimes I like to spray a little bit around the carpeting because this carpet is quite old here and we have not yet been able to replace it. So sometimes I like to spray this down before or after I vacuum as well. Your shower curtain can often get pretty musty depending upon the ventilation where you live, so I like to spray down the shower curtain. Any towels? I like to spray down the couch when I'm not doing a big deep cleaning of this. Often I will use baking soda if I have more time on my hands, or you can completely unzip all these. But y'all, this is a massive sectional, so this comes in super duper convenient, handy, all the good things that I could say about this. Good old throw pillows. And last but not least, I love using this in my vehicle for the upholstery and any sort of spills or disgustingness that my kids bring in through their sports equipment. You can also put this in your shoes. It's nice because it has the rubbing alcohol. It will help kill the bacteria and make it smell really nice with it not being too overpowering. Now, if you want to see some really clever hacks when it comes to cotton balls and clothespins, I will have those linked below. See, it's super easy. 2 ingredients aside from the water. And then what I like to do is just store it under my sink right here. And then every morning I just go ahead and grab it. I'm on my way and my house smells amazing. If you enjoyed this video, make sure that you give it a thumbs up, share it out on Facebook and Pinterest, and make sure you sign up for the weekly newsletter, which is all things cleaning tips, tricks, and hacks. And I will see you, my friend, in the next one.